This is the Star News Brief. I'm Lea Ubaga.
Religious leaders are working behind the scenes to reconcile President Uhuru Kenyatta and his deputy William Ruto. Efforts that kicked off last week appeared to be bearing fruit after Ruto's events in Nyamira that were scuttled last week were given the green light. The Star has established that the efforts to reconcile the two should culminate with a joint press conference to give a way forward on how the government is to work. There has been tension between Uhuru and Ruto since the 2018 handshake between President and opposition leader Raila Odinga.
Get a copy of The Star by subscribing to our e-paper for only 10 shillings by dialing *550*3#.
A new battleground has opened up in Parliament over a new formula for the sharing of the Constituency Development Fund. The new method could see about 100 constituencies losing money, which is likely to ignite a new war among the MPs. CDF funds are critical for MPs who ensure that the money is used to keep various promises made during the campaigns. The new formula proposes that 75% of the 41.7 billion shillings be shared equally and the rest distributed based on the number of wards in each of the 290 constituencies. As learners and teachers adjust to school routines in a coronavirus era, head teachers are facing an even bigger task to prepare for full-scale reopening in just under a month. The scarcely packed school hallways could soon be replaced with crowds of learners after Education CS George Magoha announced plans to fully reopen by November. Inside this period, greater responsibility will be with head teachers as they find gaps that could hamper learners' comfort in school and find solutions and innovations to the problems. So school heads will also be required to conduct a needs assessment on the education needs of the learners before embarking on teaching and learning. Deputy President William Ruto lacks the necessary ideas to spur economic development and create job opportunities and has resorted to issuing handouts to entice the electorate, according to Wiper leader Kalonzo Musyoka. Kalonzo said the responsibility of any leader worth the title is to create an environment in which citizens can grow economically. He said in the Grand Coalition government in which Mwai Kibaki was president, ODM leader Raila Odinga prime minister, and himself vice president, they put money in the pockets of Kenyans. Ruto's critics have lashed out at him for giving handouts to the youth 8 years later after failing to empower them since he became deputy president.
These people are exposing themselves to the scrutiny of Kenyans. Kenyans have come of age. They'll be able to look behind every act of quote-unquote philanthropy, caring for the poor, the marginalized, anti-dynasty. And I keep on saying, if you're pursuing that dynasty thing, where do you place Kalonzo Musyoka? Because Sekuru is not Sugoi.
Scientists have confirmed a person can catch COVID-19 twice, supporting a 2018 finding by Kenyan researchers that initial exposure to a coronavirus doesn't offer long-term immunity. The new confirmed COVID-19 reinfection was documented on Monday in a 25-year-old healthy American man who first contracted it in April. In June, he tested positive again, and this time experienced even more severe symptoms and required oxygen support. This is the fifth case of reinfection, the others having been reported in Belgium, the Netherlands, Hong Kong, and Ecuador. Scientists say there could be many more cases of reinfection which have simply not been profiled. Motor vehicle garage spray painters routinely complain of sore throat, headache, and dizziness. This is often attributed to their hectic work environment, but researchers point at a different cause after analyzing 110 garages in Embakasi. They found that most artisans slowly poison themselves through exposure to benzene and toluene, the sweet-smelling, highly volatile hydrocarbons and thinners added to paints. Apart from the adverse respiratory health problems, overexposure to the two chemicals can progressively lead to aplastic anemia, leukemia, and multiple myeloma.
Get a copy of The Star by subscribing to our e-paper for only 10 shillings by dialing *550*#.